Today I want to bring everyone up to speed on exactly what Sidecar XMP files are, why they're useful, and try and make this stuff interesting because, ladies and gentlemen, it's official. Sidecar XMP files are the single most boring subject in all of photography. Yeah, and we're gonna talk about it right here, right now. Yeah. Hi everyone and welcome to Pal to Tech. When you shoot photos with your digital camera, you're either saving a JPEG file or a RAW file or both. A JPEG is basically a finished image file with a JPG extension or JPEG extension, while a RAW file is really just a bunch of binary data. It's not really an image file at all. Now, on Fujifilm cameras, the RAW file has an RAF extension. Now, when you open a RAW file in Lightroom and you begin to work on it, such as changing the color, modifying the contrast, making it black and white from color, whatever, you're not actually editing or touching the Fujifilm RAW file at all. So in theory, I could spend the next 4 hours here editing a RAW file and then close out Lightroom. And then if I drag and drop the original RAW file, the RAF file, onto a thumb drive, say like this one right here, and then hand it to my friend, if he or she were to then take this thumb drive, put it in their computer, go into Lightroom and open it up, none of the changes that I made to the RAW file would appear. Rather, it would look exactly as it did when it came straight out of this camera before any editing in Lightroom. That's because Lightroom, as well as Capture One, utilizes a proprietary database that stores all of the changes you make to a RAW file. It's stored in the catalog. It's part of the Lightroom package, so to speak. And this is called non-destructive editing. The source RAW file, it's never touched, okay? So then when you're happy with the adjustments and the edits that you have made to the photo, you export the file as a JPEG, and then it's at that time, and that time only, that Lightroom or Capture One will sort of bake in all of the changes into the JPEG and then output your masterpiece. So using this workflow, which is the default when you set up Lightroom, you don't really have the ability to share changes you make in one editing program with another editing program, particularly if that program comes from a different company. Yes, you can import or export catalogs, say from Lightroom to Capture One. There's a whole migration process, that I just might cover in a future video, but not today. As far as what happens to an individual file, like on the file itself, well, what happens in Lightroom stays in Lightroom. Enter Sidecar XMP files. Sidecar files are designed to allow you to bring all of the edits and changes you make in one editing program into another editing program. Now, under the hood, a sidecar file is nothing more than a small text file that contains instructions as to what edits and changes you made to your photo. There's only ever one sidecar file per RAW file. And the single sidecar file will store all of the edits and changes to that RAW file that it's associated with. If I open up this folder, there are my RAW files from this Fujifilm camera right here. Okay, so here are my RAW files in Lightroom. Let's just pick one of them to play with. Let's go into the develop module and let's just make some very, very basic edits for sake of simplicity. I'm just gonna punch auto right here. And for kicks and giggles, I'm going to change the film sim to Acros. And at this point, I'm done. So here you can see there's my RAW file right here, and the sidecar file is given the exact same name as the original RAW file, but it has an XMP extension on it. I'm gonna open up this file right in a text editor. I'm dragging it and dropping it into here, and this, ladies and gentlemen, is what a sidecar file looks like underneath the hood. It basically is a text file that stores instructions that are then read by Lightroom. Lightroom or Capture One and then applied in those programs. It's sort of like a recipe. Think of it as handing a chef a recipe. 2 eggs, 2 teaspoons of oil, 1 cup of sugar. There's my white balance. Look, and there's my classic Chrome camera profile. Now, because I have both the RAW and the Sidecar file, if I put both of them on a flash drive, hand it to my friend, and then they go put this on their computer, open it up on their copy of Lightroom, at that point, they will bring it up and it will have all of the same edits that I have made in my copy of Lightroom. So let me show you what happens if you try and open it up in Photoshop with the Sidecar file. I am going to open in Photoshop this RAW file. Boom. Okay. You see that? All of the changes that I made in Lightroom are appearing in Adobe Camera Raw, ready to go in Photoshop. And if I open it up in Photoshop, there it is. It's right there. Now let me try it without the Sidecar file. Now here, I'm going to open it up, same thing I did before. See that? Right out of the camera. Because that Sidecar file is missing, Photoshop is opening up the original RAW file without any recipe, without any instructions. Therefore, you are seeing what it looks like right when you shot it off the camera. Another great use for Sidecar files is if you're culling through your photos using a program called Photo Mechanic. I use Photo Mechanic every single day because it's blazing fast and I can quickly go through and examine and delete the rejects when I take them off the camera after a shoot. Then what I've started doing for those photos that I like, I can assign, say, 4 stars to them because Photo Mechanic actually creates the Sidecar file. So when I go to import the photos into Lightroom, the Sidecar file comes with it and my star ratings are now there waiting for me. Let me show you this. This is so cool. I have Photo Mechanic open. I'm gonna drag and drop the files from the camera right into Photo Mechanic. There they are. And I'm gonna go through them. Boom, space bar. All right, no, I don't like that one. Okay, and let's say I kind of whittle it down. These are my keepers. And then I go back and I can quickly shuttle through them. And I kind of go, well, ooh, I kind of like that one. That one I like. So now I'm gonna give it a rating. There's a keyboard shortcuts for it, but I'm just gonna click right here so you can see it. I'm gonna give it a 4-star rating. You see that right there? So now I'm gonna import those photos that I just star rated in Photo Mechanic. I'm gonna bring them into Lightroom. Let's see what happens. And look at that. See there? There's my starred photo. If I go attributes, sort by only 4 stars, there it is. So I can quickly cull the photos in Photo Mechanic, which is much faster than Lightroom, delete the ones I don't like, apply star ratings to the ones that I do, and then import those into Lightroom. And because of the magic of the Sidecar files, it brings that data into Lightroom waiting for me when they're there. One thing you need to be careful of with this, if you're making these star ratings in a program like Photo Mechanic and you're bringing them into Lightroom, when you're going to do the import, make sure that metadata is set to none. If you have a metadata preset and you bring them in, it won't correctly bring in those star ratings that you've made in Photo Mechanic. I tore my hair out trying to figure this one out, but just put metadata to none if you're gonna do this. Okay, a couple of important points to know about Sidecar files. As I said before, Lightroom does not enable Sidecar files by default. Now you can set Lightroom to always save changes and use Sidecar files. Here's how you do that. You go into Lightroom, Catalog Settings. In Catalog Settings, you go to Metadata, and it's right here. Automatically write changes to XMP, tick that box, and then restart Lightroom. And then from that point forward, once you do that, every single RAW file you work with from now on will have an associated Sidecar file created for it automatically. One thing you need to be aware of, if you do set Lightroom to do this, it will impact Lightroom's performance because Lightroom is now gonna constantly be writing changes to these Sidecar files as you're editing your photos. How much performance will be impacted is going to depend on the type of computer you have, how fast it is, the processor, your hard disk, and all those sorts of things. So you're gonna need to experiment with this. I say Tick it on, see what happens. See if you even notice a performance change. Another option that you can do if you don't want to go full doing Sidecar all the time is you can turn it on and generate a Sidecar file on an image by image or batch of images basis. Okay, really simple to do this. All you have to do is select an image. And once you've made your changes to it and you're happy, what you can do is do on the keyboard. If you're using a Mac, it's Command S. If you're using Windows, it's Control S. You see this dialog box come up, click continue. And if you look now, it has created a sidecar file for this image, which then you can use and have. Okay, for the second thing, DNG files don't use sidecar files. DNG actually saves the sidecar file data right inside the DNG file itself. Sidecar files are really only used for raw files that come with Fujifilm, like the RAF file. Canon has the CR3, Nikon has NEF, Sony has ARW, and so forth. Number three, if you set your Lightroom catalog to start using sidecar files, your program setting preferences will only apply to that single catalog. If you want automatic sidecar saving for multiple Lightroom catalogs, you're gonna need to go into each catalog and then make that setting change I showed you earlier. Number four, if you do change Lightroom to start using sidecar files, remember this. Any photos that you've edited before you make this change will not have sidecar files applied. This only affects photos edited from this point forward. However, you could still use the Command S, Control S keyboard shortcut I just mentioned to do this on a single photo. Or, here's a tip, you can go into the library module's thumbnail view and select multiple photos first, and then do your Command S, Control S to generate a bunch of sidecar files for multiple photos. Only certain changes you make can be read by sidecar files in specific photo applications. So for example, it might allow me to bring into Lightroom my star ratings, but it won't allow me to bring in any cropping that I do in another program like Photo Mechanic. So for this reason, I only really used Photo Mechanic to cull through quickly and assign star ratings. I think it's important for any photographer to know how all of this stuff works under the hood. And therefore, even subjects as boring as sidecar files, you know, it's another tool in your arsenal. It's something that you know that can help you one day if you're having trouble. I'm sidecar filed out. If you like the video, please give it the like and subscribe. I'm gonna get out of here. I'm gonna shut the camera off. I'm gonna have a great weekend. I hope you do the same. And I will see you soon in another video. Take care.